Knock, knock, knock.
Come in.
Hello, Mrs. Rice. How are you today?
Good, how are you?
Good, I'm just doing some hand hygiene. My name is Stacy. I'm going to be your nurse this evening. I'm here to do a physical assessment. It should only take me about 10 minutes to complete. I want to thank you for letting me take care of you, and I promise to do the best that I can today.
Thank you.
Okay. First thing I need to do is ask you your name and date of birth.
Christine Rice, 22172.
Okay, do you have any allergies?
Penicillin.
Okay, and what happens when you have penicillin?
I get a rash.
You get a rash, okay. Well, we'll make sure that's on your documentation so that we don't try to give you any penicillin or anything like that. Okay, so the first thing I'm doing is I'm gonna note my patient's airway. Their airway is clear, their breathing is normal, they're not labored, they're on room air, so no use of oxygen, no use of accessory muscles. They're perfusing well. I know they're perfusing well because their skin tone is appropriate for that ethnicity. She's not jaundiced, she's not blue, anything like that, cyanotic. The next thing I'm going to look at is I'm going to make sure that my bed is in the lowest position, which it is, that I have two side rails up on both sides. Her call light is within reach. There is a clear path to the bathroom, and she has no modality, so she has no IV hanging, she has no oxygen, anything of that nature. So the next thing I'm going to do is ask you a couple questions. Can you tell me where you are right now?
Shady Sides Court Nursing.
Okay, do you know what month it is?
September.
Okay, and the year?
23.
And who's the president?
Biden.
Okay. My patient is alert and oriented times 3. Next thing I'm going to have you do is, can you smile for me? Can you puff up your cheeks? Raise your eyebrows? Good. Your face is symmetrical. Next, I'm going to take a look at your eyes. So I'm going to shine this pen light in your eyes, okay? So. Equal round reactive to light. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to have you look at my pen light and just look right behind the pen light. Look at the pen light and then the wall behind the pen light. Good. And they accommodate. So if pupils are equal round reactive to light and accommodate. Can you open your mouth for me, please? I'm going to look in your oral mucosa. It's pink and it's moist. Dentition is good. Do you have any difficulties with swallowing?
No.
No? Okay, if I give you this cup of water, you won't have any issues. Can you sit up for me a little bit so you don't choke? Okay, thank you. No issues with swallowing.
Okay.
All right. Next, I'm going to take a look. We're going to listen to your lungs. I'm just looking at your front, anterior, and we're looking to make sure that you are symmetrical on the front. I am going to take a listen to your lungs. 6 spots on the front. Deep breath in and out. Every time I move my stethoscope, I want you to take a deep breath in and out for me. Lungs are clear in all lobes. Again, I'm noting that my patient is not using any accessory muscles. She is on room air. She is breathing at a normal rate. She is not using any effort. So I'm going to move on to my cardiac assessment. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to listen to your apical pulse, which is the 5th intercostal space, mid-clavicular line. So I'm going to feel for my intercostal spaces and count down. 3, 4, 5. Can you lift, do you mind lifting up your breast tissue for me, please? Thank you. So I'm going to sit here and I'm going to count for a full minute to make sure that my rate is regular or if it's irregular. So I've counted for a full minute. Heart rate is 60 with a regular rhythm. Okay. Next I'm going to just feel your pulses. So I'm going to start on your carotids one at a time. Okay. Pulses are equal bilaterally there. I'm going to take your pulses, your radial pulses, they are equal bilaterally. I'm just going to count your radial pulse to make sure it's equal with your apical pulse at this time. And I'm counting for 30 seconds and your respiratory rate was 16. I'm going to come down here and feel your fetal pulses. those are also equal bilaterally. While I'm down here, I'm gonna look to see if you have any edema on your lower extremities, which you do not. I'm gonna check your capillary refill down here as well on both sides. There is, to make sure that we have good perfusion, which we do. I'm gonna wash my hands, gonna touch your toes, and I'm going to do the same thing. Can you give me your fingers? I'm gonna check your capillary refill on the fingers, which are good, and then check for any edema, which you have no edema, and capillary refill is less than 3 seconds. So next, I'm gonna move on to my abdominal assessment. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna look, I'm gonna see if there's any wounds or lesions on the abdomen, which she does not have any. Next, I'm going to listen, which I'm gonna start in the right lower quadrant. Sounds are present in all four quadrants, and then I'm just going to take a feel and palpate. Any pain on palpation?
Nope.
Okay, good. Have you had a bowel movement today?
Yesterday.
Yesterday, okay. How often do you typically feel? Every day, every other day?
Every day or every other day.
Okay, and how's the consistency of it?
Normal formed.
Normal form, brown? Okay. Have you urinated yet today?
Yes.
Okay, and how did you have any issues with urination?
No.
Pain, frequency, urgency?
No.
Nothing of that nature. And what was the color like?
Lemonade
color. Okay, good. So that is it for my abdominal assessment. Now I'm going to move down to my neuromuscular assessment. So can you lift your arms up like this? Your little YMCA for me. Okay, good. All right. Full range of motion on the uppers. And then do me a favor, bend one knee at a time. Lift this up. And then you can do that. You can put them down. Thank you very much. Full range of motion in the upper and the lower extremities. Next, I'm going to have you squeeze my fingers. Okay. Strength is equal bilaterally in the upper extremities, and then I'm going to have you push against my hands like a gas pedal, toes to the nose, and strength is equal bilaterally on your feet. I'm going to wash my hands again. Any numbness or tingling, fingers, legs, toes?
No.
Okay. Can you get up and walk for me?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you have a stable gait?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Go ahead and stand. I want you to take a few steps. And come on back. Watch your shoes. We don't want you tripping. Okay, you can have a seat. So, steady gait. Next, I'm going to go into my skin assessment. So, color again is perfect for your ethnicity. You are warm to the touch, you're dry. Check your skin trigger up here. You have good less than 3 seconds, which means you're well hydrated. I'm looking and assessing to see if there are any wounds or lesions anywhere in your body. Can you turn that way for me too? I'm gonna look at your backside. I see no wounds or lesions. I see no areas of redness that might require blanching, to check for blanching. Okay, you can roll back over. The patient is answering my questions appropriately. She is making eye contact. Do you have a support person?
Yes, I have a husband to help.
Is he gonna come in later tonight?
Mm-hmm.
Is he?
Yeah.
Oh, good, wonderful. And then do you have any religious beliefs that you wish to be met while you're here?
Yeah, I would like to see a pastor.
Okay, we can put that in your chart to make sure they come up and see you, okay?
Thank you.
All right, so that concludes my physical assessment. I'm just gonna wash my hands and I'm gonna go document my findings.
Thank you.
Thank you.